Kurzyzyk sent me his invention from Poland. It's a square drill, but not what you think it is. So let's open her up. And this is the thing. The drill. So this is a square drill, but it's for drilling round holes. But the drill is square for jigging things up with. This is for drilling two holes at the same time. That goes on like this. Ah, yes. And two screws, and that makes it a double drill. Foot pedal. Slight problem, 240 volt plug. So my understanding is this is a 240 volt device, because it is from Poland. But he put this label on here, 110 volts. So I'm gonna hook this up to 120 volts and see how it runs. So before I make permanent changes to this thing, I'm just gonna hook up this power cord to the plug. Well, that runs pretty vigorously, so I'm pretty sure that's a 120 volt version. So the idea of this thing is that the housing is a precise shape, and I've realized the numbers on here actually mean that the spindle is 32 millimeters from this side, 32 from this side, and 33.5 probably from this side. So I flip it on its side, it says 33.5 on this side, 37 here. I like that labeling. And measuring that housing, almost 0.2 millimeters over 64 millimeters. So a little bit bigger than it says. I'm guessing it's the thickness of the paint. The back is about 0.04 millimeters over. So that's not bad. So to test runout on this chuck here, I need to tighten that down really good, and that needs a 12 meter wrench, a fairly thin one. I didn't have one, so I just ground out a 10 millimeter wrench, and let's tighten that up good and try again. That's pretty good for a drill. The idea of this drill is that it's easy to jig something up because you can just guide it like that. And I'll try to make a rather difficult partial cut with a Forstner bit into a piece of wood. The drill feels super solid, but I think this may not be stiff enough to do this successfully. So I swapped out that square for a big piece of plywood for more steady support, but that drill still got away on me a bit. So for my next test, I just drilled square into the wood, which made it much easier, but again, still a bit too much cutting forces with that big Forstner bit on the end of it. So then I tried it with a smaller Forstner bit, and this time it worked perfectly. And even that hole would be hard to do on a drill press. I'd say that's a pretty clean mortise. So I had to make this extra spacer to get that right, and I also used these little spacers to get the pattern of holes for one of these hinges. But I'm not sure if this is the best way of doing that sort of thing. Certainly if using one of these fancy carbide bit Forstner bits, you can't very easily guide these, but if you're using a cheap fastener, but you could just make a wooden guide and it would glide quite nicely in the guide hole. So I'm not sure if this is a particularly good way of using this drill to make the holes for these European hinges. So I just mounted the double drill head on there and just playing around with that. That makes two holes spaced exactly 32 millimeters apart. Of course, this would make a lot more sense if I had two drills of the same size in here. And he sent along two of them of different sizes, and that's all the ones I've got, so I don't have two of the same size to put in here. These being 32 millimeters apart is perfect for a lot of mounting holes for cabinet hardware. For example, the spacing for these holes is 32 millimeters. Or for shelf pin jigs, the smaller of the drills is actually just the right size for that sort of thing. And some of these C-channels that I sent along are 64 millimeters wide and 32 millimeters tall, which means I could drill two holes like this and then get at the next position like this. Except measuring them, they're not super accurate. I could cut a spacer that's more accurate out of plywood. The drill got away on me a little bit because I was being sloppy, but it still came out pretty clean. So, awesome invention, that thing. I've been kind of at a loss as to what some of these stainless steel rails that Kurzysiak sent me are supposed to be for. Specifically, these parts here and these rails with holes every 32 millimeters. And he sent me a link to a video showing some of these pieces in action. It turns out it's all about making cabinets out of particle board using fasteners that go into the corners. And I'll include a few bits of his video that shows some of these things. I think that shows it off much better than I could. The key thing to have is a big box to use all these parts in to help line things up. And the odd-shaped brackets are for lining up holes for Euro hinges. So it appears that the target for this square drill and accessories is all about drilling holes to mount some of these cabinet hardware fasteners, which allow you to mount pieces of particle board at a right angle. Because when you think about it, commercial cabinets are all about pieces of particle board attached together at right angles. And every one of these fasteners is for attaching panels at a right angle, including hinges, really. It's just the hinges actually allow the panel to open. What I found most fascinating is this particular fastener. So this fastener is meant to go into a hole on the edge of a piece of particle board, sort of like this, and it sits in there like that, and this screws into another piece of particle board this way. And the way that screw is turned is kind of neat, because there's this part here which is meant to be whacked into here. Once this is inserted into a hole, this goes through another hole off the side. And I've driven this one in already. And then to tighten these together, you just turn this with a screwdriver. As a hobbyist, I've never really considered fasteners like this because, first of all, I never use particle board. But even for plywood, if I need to attach two pieces at a right angle, I could just put a screw through both of them, or put a dowel in there and glue it, or nail it. There's all kinds of options that are really cheap and easy, but in terms of commercial furniture, especially if it needs to be assembled from flat packs on site, that doesn't make as much sense, so it would make more sense to spend a bit more money on the hardware. So it's a completely different approach from hobby woodworkers like myself. Oh yeah, and of course you could also attach two panels at a right angle using pocket holes, which I think would be about as good as some of this hardware, but again, it doesn't make sense in terms of assembling on site and that sort of thing. So even though this is not what this drill is intended for, what I find most interesting about it is its ability to act as a handheld horizontal boring machine, and it allows me to drill holes that would be very difficult to do with any other sort of jig.